Good morning, viewers, and welcome to another edition of the program Salon Morning Discoveries with me, Aissatou Smile Cisse. And today inside the program, I get with me the outreach and communication person for the National Protected Area Authority, Wena Cornelius Ekorandul, as he can tell me plenty thing about the National Protected Area Authorities, waiting at the mandate, and also waiting at some of the work them where they do. And as we know, say they get plenty personnel where they be don't recruit. How they go about the recruitment, all that we get for know inside the program today. Good morning and welcome to the program.
Good morning, viewers. Thank you very much for having me.
Okay, they talk today about the National Protected Area Authorities. First thing we want for know, I would say viewers then go want for know these particular authorities waiting now the work where they do.
All right, thank you again for having me. The National Protected Area Authority, family we don't know and we already don't know, say it been formed by an act of parliament in 2012. And in main function and mandate where the authority may get and for provide biodiversity conservation, research, wildlife management, and protect protected areas within the country. There are 15 protected areas within the country where government designates say these areas need to be protected because of various reasons where I will tell you as we go along during the program.
Okay, so if we talk about the areas them, and viewers go on to know as you talk about the areas them away they get for protect, where these authorities they protect. Like waiting as us and some of the areas there, so.
Alright, like I say, we get 15 networks of protected areas them across the country where 8 na wetlands and 7 na terrestrial. Waiting at the difference. Wetland na usai mangrove then they. Farm will you list in and watch we no say mangrove na that tickle can locally called mango wood. It is now some area them around Freetown. It is somewhere around the provinces. We get areas like Yori Bay, where they around from Tombo to Shenge. We get the Saralu River Estuary, where they from Kambia to Kamna Peninsula. We get Lake Somfo within a Kabbalah. We get Mamuta Mayoso within a Tonkolili district. We get plenty of them where they around the country. So that's not the wetland. We talk about the terrestrial way now up the hills. Up, so we can call them bush areas then. For example, we get the Western Area Peninsula National Park. We begin from Godrich, take around the peninsula, come up Regent, Buretong, and all that area then they. Now, a protected area where government, we don't put them places in their side, say we not for do anything within the area then they. We take up the provinces. We get Utamba Kilimi National Park. The Utamba Kilimi National Park, na park we defend, na Kaine District. We in our first park where the government been designated in 1972, I think. For later area, they be a reserve, a forest reserve. You get the Tingi Hills within at the corner part, the eastern part of it. You get the Kambo Hills, it is right inside Kenematong. We also get Tonkolili, we get one at Tonkolili, Kangari Hills within at Tonkolili, we get one again within at the south, what we call Tiwai Island. So we get plenty of them, we get 15 of them, like I say. The National Protected Area Authority gets power and mandate by government for protect them places then they.
So let me talk about the wetland, and if you look like some slums areas them where you safe can know see na bank them bank na the areas then they. So now if on a meet already don't bank na the areas then they, and maybe they go don't cut some of them and go and wood then they, and the place with the way out in the bank, the place you go no say possibility day back for let and continue for the bank. So waiting on I can do for make on see say the people them way they close to the inside and they not continue for the bank.
If you can know, very recently, I think last year, the National Protected Area Authority just recruit 500 game guards, where people can call rangers, some man can call them game guard or whatever, but we can call them game guards because not designation and we'll give them. We employ them, governments here are necessary for employing them people and they, for can help we protect them places they are, just like how you just say. So maybe and they be done in existence before the act came in 2012. So you get to go back to them people and engage them, explain to them the importance of the mangrove and the risky life for them will live if they tap within the area and they. You serve the sea they happen. Where the water they can they choose whether na green or na red or na blue party with the clear all man. So I know I'll bring politics into this one. The mangrove, you know for cut them. It's risky. The mangrove then they the fish then they can lay their egg. Fish farm will you know, fish not they lay egg na the high seas. And they come very close to the mangrove, then I didn't breed them, picking them before they go into the high seas. If we cut all the mangrove, then they notice say fish safe now, you don't begin scarce. Fish don't become expensive because if fisherman and they go very far now, forget fish. Come mangrove not they for let them breed and picking them. So like I want to take this opportunity since I didn't have this medium for appeal to people who they watch me. May they not cut the mangrove. It risky for their new life, it risky for we self as human being. Not for long, no, we're not gonna get fish if we continue for destroyed mangrove.
So if a person destroyed a mangrove, if they like some mangoes, person go say, me self wants for being landlord, and the only way how we go wants for being landlord now for let it go bank, and then when I get to understanding, say it cuts the mangrove, then waiting can be the penalty.
The laws then they, but the laws are obsolete because right now the National Protected Area Authority they use the Wildlife Act of 1972. Which is very old, back up with the 2012 Act to enact the NPAA. If somebody do that, they really, they go be charged to court. Then go arrest them, can go police and be charged to court. But at the end of the day, so far, the laws are weak. I'm not going to say weak, the fines are weak. Because up till now, you fine somebody 2 million, 5 million, 100 million. So we don't go back, we law officers' departments, now we office, don't go back and try for redo then laws then they and don't forward them to the ministry. We go eventually take them to cabinet then before we go parliament for letting law then they go change. But as it is right now, if they catch you, they cut mangrove, then go arrest you, can you go police, charge you go court. If you find one thing, then they go find you something 5,000 or 10,000 leon. That's not the present law we talk now. But with time, as we look forward to the ministry and cabinet for approval and send and go parliament, it will become law way. So until next year, we cut mangrove and find you 2 million leon or 6 years jail, you're not going to do them again.
Okay, so where you be the talk, you make measure of the peninsula. So like the game guards them, where then they also work with them, they do they?
The game guards then they all over the country. They are not only placed in the Western area.
For the one them way then they're inside and they also
then roll way then they do they then they patrol at the forest and show the people then the boundary outside enough for bill, enough for go beyond this mark where they don't show them say they're not for bill. If they go there now, they meet somebody they bill, then go ask them for a document for forward in our office. We'll get a GIS department, we will look the coordinates them, check the coordinates if you fall within the protected area. And advise you say no for building. If you not fall, then go tell you say go ahead. Then go tell you say go ahead and build. Please not fall within the protected area. But one problem over again at the Western Area Peninsula National Park, when are the seat of power sitom, we will get too much challenges in our Western Area pass every other park within the country, because all man one can tap na free turn. Everybody one day na free turn. That is a big problem. So man don't can free turn for the first day. Don't see lights. They don't see television. It's why I become on television all the day, and all they go again. And they tell you, say, yeah, better pass to say, come on. So it go leave now, so. But with the appeal, with the continue for appeal to the big one, then let them continue for educate people, then let them left for being at the ill then. The environment, if you go after America, after you for sure. Let's take a simple example. If you take Dottie to where on the sea, on a gutter, water and go, you go notice after some time that until they come back now the ground. And if you continue for the door, how will the pile when it can? It can in revenge. And at that time you go get flooding, aiwata, and all that stuff then.
So what about the one them we can go deep into the forest for go get stone where they mine that stone?
That is another problem. Stone mining, you get stone mining, you get charcoal burners and all that thing in there. Nothing no wrong for let you mine stone. Nothing no wrong for let you do charcoal. But with problem like National Protected Area Authority will get, designated area wouldn't say for reserve, no go cost charcoal there. If you look at them forest then, most times you get the protected area one side, but you get community forest. Forest and they will not to protected areas. You can do that, you can cut thick and burn charcoal. But make sure say for every thick where you cut, you plant two or three. Then they will help you for next season, for let you be able to forget you tick for making charcoal. But if you don't cut all thing this season, next season that's not good again, then we'll all go to square one and suffer.
Okay, and also where you talk about the game guard, I go want for no like where you talk about the recruitment way on do. So how on able to forget them people there, so where on recruit like some of the qualifications them away on look inside.
The game guards, the recruitment, we do them all over the country because we'll not be one for be bias. We do them right across the country. Better for you recruit somebody where they a particular area than you take somebody from Freetown and send and go to area where you not come out or you not sabi. The work not going to become effective. So like we get people them, Now then we get offices across the country, we get at the district, now the regions them. We now when we advertise the job, they apply to the region and they and send and come free to the human resource department, process them very well and see the people that we qualify for take for the job. We take 500, not forget to we get 300, maybe look small. But we later on ask for permission and then grant you the permission for recruit another 500. We don't get who believe say don't go right across the country now and we try for protected and protected areas there.
So where will they talk about the game guards them, and also we can see them with a uniform where ABC is so green like the army person we don't know the different go just think say oh na American so because they get the same uniform. Why the green?
Well, generally all over the world, if you look across Africa, so if you go notice the rangers people already take care of forest, their uniform na green. But we'll be very technical when we pick this uniform because we mean get the military involved in the training of them people there. So if you observe keenly, you notice that the uniform is different because they get a black epaulette here, then get black at the pocket and black stripe at the trousers. So that the show say they are not military guys. And the name and the NPA logo, they write at the chest here for proof say this is not a military person.
So like them work there, so we wanna recruit them people there, so for what you know they aim for achieve. And also, when I get any mandate, like a goal where when I go don't set, say, from this time to this time, we want for this certain thing will be achieved.
What do we want for achieving the National Protected Authority? Now, for make sure, say, people are not billows, who sign enough for billows. People are not for cut tick, who sign enough for cut tick. People are not for broke stone, who sign enough for broke stone. Now, that we really want for achieve. So, now that's the reason we make, we recruit some people there. So, send them go up to the forest, send them go to the wetlands, send them go to the provinces, let them protect the area, then they stop people for do the wrong thing we don't know for do within the protected area. That's the reason. And the target plan is from the time they recruit them, tell this year they done, we rate them again for see how improve that process they don't be.
So now get any plan for recruit another game guards?
Well, for now we just recruit first this year. We not get money yet for do that, but we watch the way I waiting and do, and if they can perform more, if it's necessary for law recruit more, definitely I believe the government will support we for recruit more.
So like I'm waiting at some of the challenges we on the face.
Number one, are logistics. Number two, we only get funding from government for now. The corona and the right around the world don't make funding don't become very, very, very difficult because people are not going to take care of their own country and they can't help other people. So that's now the main challenges we get. Sponsorship, because government as a whole not going to do everything. The protected areas in plenty. The work for be done in plenty. You get forget people around the clock for the go around them forest here. See say people are not do waiting they not for do. Sierra Leoneans were very tangaes. When they talk, you talk today, then go listen. Tomorrow if you relax small, then go do the wrong thing. So you get for the do and continuously. It's a continuous process. Therefore continuously they do one.
Okay, make our holiday first as we go for break, then we go come back. And don't forget to say the program we didn't listen to, na Salon Morning Discoveries with me, Aizatus Maisise, and inside the studio, we still get Cornelius Ekorando, we come out from NPAA as it tell me plenty thing about the National Protected Area Authorities. We go for short break.
Sierra Network is the network that bridges the gap between the diasporas and those within Sierra Leone by providing authentic and factual news on a daily basis.
We at Sierra Network Salon take pride in quality and productivity is our utmost priority in service delivery to the communities we serve.
We expect and professionalism at all times.
Our service to the people of Sierra Leone is paramount in what we do.
We constantly strive for innovation and the best that meets the demands of the people in Sierra Leone.
Our passion and creativity oversees the work we produce.
We work as a team to provide you the best in news, media, comedy, entertainment, and all your event coverages.
Sierra Network is here to offer you the best.
We engage the people to learn about Sierra Leone's culture and history.
This is AAA, from Sierra Network.
This is Dr. Aisatu Kake Jallo from Sierra Network Health Talk and Discoveries.
This is Ishmael Dadis Bangua from Sierra Network Comedy and Production.
This is Abib Kaloko from Sierra Network Media.
This is Sila Kemtakabu from Sierra Network Media.
This is Aisatu Smai Sese from Sierra Network Talk to the Camera.
This is Kona Sese from Sierra Network Talk to the Camera.
This is Samuel Bright from Sierra Network Media.
This is Mohamed Eskagbu from Sierra Network Production and Comedy.
This is Justice AM Tijan from Sierra Network Media.
This is Salima Sukake from Sierra Network Tell Me Salon.
Sierra Network Salon, where Sierra Leone is never too far, at 56 Campbell Street, second floor, Freetown, Sierra Leone. You can call us at +232 77 425 637 or +1 646 610 3107 or visit us on the web at snradio.net or sncfny.org.
The program Salon Money Discoveries, they continue, and inside the studio, and I don't forget to say, I deal with the outreach and communication person for the National Protected Area Authority, Wena Cornelius Ekurandu, as a day inside the studio for can tell we more about the National Protected Area Authorities. So as we did talk earlier before we go break, I go want for make you tell we like some of the areas then where you talk about the protection where on the give, where the authorities they give, why on a decide for protected areas then they?
All right, like I say, some of them places then they, now governments we don't designate them for keep them as protected area because of one reason or the other. Some get some particular species then they where not they don't sign as Sierra Leone or some not even then at the wall. So, for example, like at the Otamba Kilimi National Park, at the park where we get elephants, and at the park land where we come in a trap door already see a lion. So, that they be necessary for letting with man we can do research at that park day those days, and I make them in Gola Park, the Otamba Kilimi National Park. So, now the reason I make government look say, well, since then, here they exist now inside the country, let's keep this area. Let it be a national park where. If possible, do research. If possible, see a particular animal, it can come at this park and see some of them seen in there. You take the Campbell Hills, you take the Gola Rainforest. Gola Rainforest, now a simple board, now in the wet man and see we make them come as alone. That board they like they make the people around Gola the forest, then they benefit because they don't protect that area there for see that particular type of body. I don't forget the biological name for the board. A day in that park, now they no more a day in Sierra Leone. And very recently, they don't come find out, say, we get a species of crocodile. We na salon no more, they wouldn't call it draft crocodile. Na salon no more, they. So, because of them, then they protect their areas and they follow up with man them and even black man, Africans, can Sierra Leone, for can do a research on them particular species. Then they. And the reason they will make the forefathers them look unnecessary, say, no, keep them places there. For make let people then come and do their research and see some of them see how they don't want to see now other parts of the country. I tell you, my sister, if you go to Otamba Kilimi National Park, you're not going to believe seeing a Sierra Leone today. Very beautiful place. You go see down there, you see the footprints of the elephants them. You go see various type of dikers there, who can call deer, bush buck, who can call fritambo. You go see them plenty around. You go even notice different type of monkey, different type of chimpanzee then they. Where you go glad you for see the area. You don't go even think seeing a Sierra Leone today. I'm telling you go glad you send a salon this all them fine thing they are so in this country, but oh my god, the problem will get not impact them the timber logging is another big problem. The people when they cut timber, nothing no wrong for cut timber, but like I say, a protected area, you know, for use them for cut timber because government now they make money with timber. Now I see them, they talk on the radio, see they don't can give almost $1 million to government funding from timber, but not forget, so oh, they cut the timber, so oh, they destroy the park. then they destroy the environment because now they cut that terekapos, the tree named them terekapos, so then they cut for timber. Then they cut that tree, they now, they're not a plant, they're not even think for plants. So you pull timber today, you pull and tomorrow, you pull and next tomorrow, it will reach a point where timber not go available again. Then we come back to the same thing. We would done in a salon from 1930 to the invent diamond a salon. Say till diamond no better we. Now timber will physically come better we. We waste to them. We cut the timber, we destroy the environment will get back at we, we not go get nothing we will benefit. The Chinese man they buy the timber, now China then they go make with her. Then they make the product, then bring them back in Africa, then can sell and give it their one. So you see timber logging is a big problem. Me not say let them not cut timber, but Papa government to the big one idea, let them cut timber outside them for cut timber. And every timber wouldn't they cut, let them plant for replace the one they wouldn't they cut. If you go on that road, you take that Kamakwe Road for go take Karine. You go shake your head in that road, where you see. First of all, the road, then they pull the road because the truck that they pass with timber. And they destroy the road, destroy the environment, all in the name of $10, $20, $100. The people went down at the village, they actually know the benefits from that timber that they cut to that environment today. So you see, me the big government, let them left this timber business. Or let them make special site where they cut timber. Because we don't go there, we don't make arrest, we don't count the people in our police, cow then are cut at the end of the day, then they left there and then still they go again at the park for cut the timber.
Because now that I just want to ask, say this particular parkway we already get on a game garden day and then the timber business still they continue there. So like what are some of the things then like where you go want exactly for they then go do for that particular parkway? Because as you say, when they get arrested on a car with the people them, then at the same time they release them. So what type of support you think say we are going to need from the government for the people left for cut timber on that side?
Well, originally before the recruitment of the 500 game guards, we been get about 17 guards them now. Otamba Kelime National Park. The park is about 110,500 and something hectares of land, which is very, very, very big. It go to almost reach Guinea border from which side. So 15 people will not be able now. Some of the reason and the justification and we'll get to government will make them allow we for recruit. Now we don't get over 100 or 200 guards them now that park. A little bit better, small than before. They better now because then they do patrol, then they all of what, and we don't get a good relationship with the police, the asylum police, and the ISLAF. As we talk now, the asylum police don't get an office inside the National Protected Area Authority, where we get a all superintendent for CC, they work with regards them for protect them park there. So now it better because them park there where they talk, so I don't work on at all. I they still get sympathy for the people of Karine district because really, really. Then they destroy that environment there. And they not go born good picking tomorrow. The environment where you go after her, they can after you. For sure. The environment they can after you, where you go after them.
So when you talk about this particular park, you make measure of the kind of species that we then did it, like we get the elephant, we get like lion. So that the animal then still exist in Salon.
They still they exist. In fact now the elephant and the can are the tongue for among the people there. Because every day power so they outside then they live. So when they want to eat, and they can't have the farm, the community farm, then and they can't destroy. We'll be getting a report the other day, then tell we say let them not kill the animal then, but then they can't have the tongue and destroy. So we have to tell them the reason. If you don't destroy the man outside it, you see it's outside available, and they can't for can't find the food. We still get them. The lion, we don't set another camera trap for ensure saying at the park today because there is a speculation say it's likely say come out Conakry, it can pass in a saloon and go back. So we don't set camera trap then day for ensure say they're able for see and back and prove say the lion at Sierra Leone is still there.
Okay. What's the message where you go out to all waiting you don't say so as this program they can't to an end now?
We want for appeal to we listeners and viewers them. We want really appeal to una. Una take the word out to community people them. Una take the word out to una family them around una say if you destroy the environment will definitely destroy you. So not cut thick, not to wait dot in and cut away in the camp. Not burn charcoal inside the protected area. Not broke stone, not do sand mining outside our wetland, not cut mangrove. If you do them, it will come back to you. Surely it will come back to you. And we're not going to like follow within our office and call, we say, what I don't swell at social area. The good thing, we know them here, and I make the pass over to now. Because we know that they will, If we not die now, and people then go really suffer. Not so we not get for today, but we not like that. We not want a situation where then they can call me in the office say, hey, people they don't die, people they don't broke, people they don't this, people they don't that. We really not want for that. So we want for appeal to now with the watch we do here, and I pass the word around to people then. Don't destroy the environment so that the environment will not get back to you.
Yes, as soon as I listen to the outreach and communication person for the National Protected Area Authorities, the word we left with today is say, let we not destroy the environment, because if we destroy the environment will come back to we. That's so this program will come to an end for today. Me wake out this program to now today. Me your name na Aizatus Maisise. Until we meet again to another edition of the program Salon Morning Discoveries, I say, ta-ta.